Hello, folks. Good evening. My name is Graham Walker. And I'm welcoming you to something very special tonight. I'm welcoming you to 1878. Yes, we're going to time travel. We've got something very, very special and exciting to tell you about. And obviously, you've just seen a little bit of a sneak peek glimpse there. And this is the Civic Barnsley, where we're actually, we've got two virtual tours. And the main one is about a retro stepping back in time, literally, to the day that it opened. 143 years ago, nearly 150 years. And I've got some great guests with me tonight. We're going to be talking to Marcus Abbott, who is the designer of the retro tour. We're also going to be talking to Luke Robson from the Civic Barnsley, and also to Tegwyn Roberts, who's going to be from Barnsley Museums, telling us all about this fantastic project. So first up, I'm going to bring Marcus into the party and just have a little chat with him before we give you that first look. Stick with this, folks. You're just absolutely going to love it. Hi, Marcus. How are you doing?
Good evening, Graham. How are you?
I'm all right, thank you. I better for seeing you here and joining me tonight. You're the expert at these things. Just tell me, it's fascinating what you've managed to achieve. Before we just show that, can you just tell us exactly what you've done and why you've done it?
Okay, so what we were asked to do at TJC Heritage was to build a three-dimensional model, a virtual model of the building as it would have been sort of around about the day that it opened, and to basically create that. And then what we can do in that is then we can film within that model and produce a panoramic tour and kind of like a virtual museum exhibit in one of the rooms. And that's essentially what we've created here for you.
Yeah, it is. It's remarkable. There's also a modern day mapping of the building as well, so you can actually literally time jump from one room to the other, which is just incredible. And I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to actually take people on the tour and take them around it. But we've put a bit of composite video together earlier, so I'm just going to bring that up into the stream, and we can talk our way through it. Hopefully, if we can. There we go. So can you just tell me a little bit about what we're looking at and what's happening here then, Marcus?
So this is the facade, and the main thing about that was the bottom with the shops. So there are a load of shops in the bottom.
And there's where we transported into the future, wasn't it, as well? So we've got these
right,
spots
we're jumping into that, into the actual, we're going through the doorway, now we're in the hallway. So the hall that leads, the passage that leads up to the staircase. And this is like the two staircases that run off. There's one surviving staircase in the building at present. And you can see that.
There we go. Yeah.
Beautiful cut there.
And then this is on the tour where we're actually in the modern day building. Yeah. And we've got Luke, who's with us tonight, and he's doing things like uncovering the original floor tiles and taking us around. And you can jump between one and the other, yeah?
That's correct, yeah. You can link between the two tours in specific geolocations. So you're seeing the same thing, but back in time.
So, this part of the building is accessible, but this isn't, isn't it? This is a wall now, as we can see there.
That's right, and the doorways are not there, and the library's not there, and the reading room. So it's,
But here we can walk through, and this is the reading room.
Yep, and this is where the exhibition is, which tells you all about the different people who are involved, the performances, all sorts of stuff. Loads of content.
Lots of information points in here as well. In fact, we've got some audio later, I think, of some of the recreated dramas that we saw there, like Cinderella other things, yeah. I must admit, I've just absolutely loved this project, working on it and looking around it. It's knowing when to actually close your laptop and go to bed.
Well, you just got to keep looking, you see. You got to look around. You've got 360 degree views, so you can look up, you can look around, you can see all the fine details. It's all in there. So.
It is remarkable. And then, of course, this is the modern day building that's been mapped. And as you can see, there's like a doll's house effect to this. This is the entrance where we've just walked in the retro version. And then this is the way that you actually walk to that bottom staircase now, because you can't get through the main entrance, not yet. And then up this grand staircase, and as you can see, lots of little information points sticking around there. Click on those, find a lot of information. Back into the kind of a doll's house effect. It is quite stunning, and I must admit the architecture inside is it's still very familiar, isn't it? You did a remarkable job building the retro version.
Well, it's all based on the actual architecture that's there. So we laser scanned everything, well, not everything, everything we wanted first, so that the outside and then that corridor was laser scanned, so we'd have copies of what was actually there, so we could build within that framework.
We've a number of people who've already joined us. If you are watching, folks, tell us where you're watching from and any special memories you've got. Mary Abodo is saying, I worked at the Civic from 74 to 76. Happy times. So, got lots of other people on. It's very clever. Well done. Thanks, Jenny. I'm sure Marcus will appreciate your comments.
I do.
a lot of hard work's gone into this, Marcus. How long's it taken to actually build it?
It's hundreds of hours of work if you think about it, you know, because every little bit, so every cornice and skirting board, all of that data we took from the laser scan data and the profiles, we made those. So we're trying to make it as authentic as possible using the data that we have. Then we've got all the maps, plans and sections and things that we were actually trying to incorporate, and the tile floor, which took quite a while to design, and was we basically had photographs of the individual tiles to put together.
Yeah, absolutely amazing. Well, what I'm going to try and do is actually see if we can actually bring the tour in, and we can have a play around with it and see just how easy it is to navigate around here. I'll just try and do that while we're looking at the screen here. Just remind you as well that Barnes, that we're putting up details on the bottom of here of how people can actually take this tour straight after we finish with this as well. So it is available now, Marcus, isn't it?
Yes, it's online now and live. Yeah, went up today.
And here we go. So this is the tour. In fact, if I refresh it, it actually has got a lovely sweeping shot, hasn't it, at the front of the building?
Yeah, we start. It's to sort of remind you to look around.
And that's the address, folks, that you keep seeing on the bottom as well. So please explore this in detail. So if you click on these little markings, it takes you through, doesn't it? So this is into the entrance hall, where we've just seen the modern day version of it as well. And the thing is to look up. I mean, there's some amazing architecture here that you would miss if you just went straight along the journey. But clicking these will move you more into the building. And as we approach here, I think this is where the tiles are on the floor.
That's correct.
There we go. And straight ahead of us, that's a wall now, isn't it? But here we go. This is the reading room area.
That's the reading room. Yeah.
And if you click on these particular buttons here, these will take you to the modern day version. And there's links back as well, so you can find your way around. Well, let's just stroll inside here then, Michael. So just tell me what we're looking at and what the functionality is.
So what you're looking at is essentially, we've designed the reading room. So the furniture is authentic from other reading rooms and from photographs of the time. So you've got these big desks, and then you've got the sort of, so the big desks you put like plans and sections and engineering drawings on. So these ones you stand up at and you actually look at your data. And then the other ones are much lower down with the chairs. So we've kept that a kind of like authentic look. And then within that, we've added different elements about the building, about the performances there, about the people there, and all of that information. As you can see, you can click on it and read about it. You can pull up the images, and there are loads of brilliant audio snippets that you can listen to.
Yeah, I think some of these posters have been reimagined, haven't they? I don't think they were live, but
they're real posters. Yes. Yeah. They've been reimagined for the exhibition, so they're not original. Like the recordings aren't original either. They're dramatizations of events that happened, but based on actual events and actual performances.
Yeah, I believe that there are also some audio in here as well. And in fact, we're going to actually play a little bit of that just to give people an idea of what they can listen to, because you've actually brought to life some of the players, some of the productions that took part down there, like And I think the opening of the Civic as well, the mayor's speech, I think you've recreated that. Just incredible.
Yeah, Mark Tollison wrote that and performed all of that for us and recorded it all. So there's like six or seven, I think, different performances that he's done for us.
We've got a little bit of a bit of that here. I'm just going to play this. So it's really important just to give him a mention. This is Mark Tillotson from Mark Productions. He's I think local artists have used and Mark is an actor, writer, and he's helped to put this together. So here's just a little taster, but please go in and explore it for yourselves.
The mayor, who wore his robes and chain of office, performed the ceremony of declaring the hall open. His worship was accompanied by several of the directors and others. The mayor was received with loud cheers.
Ladies and gentlemen, when my colleagues elected me to high office I now fill, my most ardent hopes never soared so high as the honour I now sustain today.
Hark, I hear music at the palace o'er yonder, where chandeliers light up the prince's salle. What would I give to be there?
So you shall.
Some peeress? What a strange way to appear.
I am your fairy godmother, my dear.
What?
Your sisters, as of course I needn't tell ye, don't use you well. At least not usually.
Twelve long, tedious months have passed, and no tidings of William. Shame upon the unkind hearts that parted us, that sent my dear husband to dare the perils of the ocean, and made me a pining, miserable creature.
There she is, like a caged nightingale, singing her heart out against her prison bars. For this cottage is little better than a prison.
This powerhouse of a man will astound you by lifting and pressing such weight that it has been deemed necessary for the management to reinforce the stage with steel girders from beneath. In Hull, Mr. Dinny lifted the fattest man in the country. In Doncaster, he lifted a pit pony, but with one hand. Tonight, he will lift a platform upon which will not only be one but two legendary acrobats that you have witnessed tonight. The Incredible Falcons, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, there we go. Lovely comments coming in as well, Marcus, and which is
I saw some of those.
Really nice to see.
Yeah.
Keep those coming, folks. If you've got a couple of minutes and you can share with us a comment, it'd be great to see them and use the hashtag Barnsley Civic 1878. So that's a little look, and we're gonna do a little bit more. We're gonna look at the new tour as well. But what I'm gonna do, Marcus, I'll bring you back in a little while. But first of all, behind every great project, there's a great woman. And there's also a great funding pot. And I'm talking about Tegwyn Roberts from Barnsley Museum. Hi, Tegwyn, how are you?
Hi, Graham. Absolutely brilliant. That just looks so good. It's just so fantastic to see all this come together. Really exciting.
It's lovely as well to see so many people saying so many lovely things about the place as well, isn't it? I mean, it's heartwarming to know that how well loved that building is. And now what history it's got. But we're talking 143 years.
And that was part of the idea for this project, was to, particularly with the grand entrance from Eldon Street, and really help people reconnect with the building in that way. Just to see all the lovely comments coming in and the memories is just fantastic.
We just need, there's so many people to mention. I have been joking that you're coming on to give the Oscar speech, but there is that many people to thank, isn't there? And we just mentioned Mark Tillotson, who wrote and produced the audio as well, didn't he, what we've just heard. Look, I'm going to say take it away and just name check everybody who's been involved in this project, because it's been quite staggering, the cast of thousands.
Well, yeah, I mean, absolutely massive thanks to Mark for the brilliant work that he's done, and James Brandon for helping to produce the audio. Also to Patrick Murphy, a local artist who's done all of the posters for us. And they're based on original posters from the Barnsley archives with original historic adverts from the newspapers and everything. So they've done an amazing job. Also, huge thanks to my colleagues in Barnsley Museums and Barnsley Archives, who've put so much work into kind of the research that sits behind this project, because without that, we just wouldn't have all the information that we do. And we're just uncovering so many interesting things about this building. And I think it's worth saying that this is just the start. So we focused on the early years, but we would love to extend this and to focus on some of the later years. We haven't even started to talk about when it became a library. And I mean, because the Civic was basically built for the people of Barnsley to enable them to access education, art and culture. And that's just an amazing story and unfolds over the last 143 years. This was part of the Eldon Street High Street Heritage Action Zone, which is a partnership project, a really exciting partnership project between Barnsley Council and Historic England. So for the next 4 years, the High Street House will be working on Eldon Street to rejuvenate the High Street as part of the regeneration of Barnsley Town Centre, and to celebrate, research and celebrate the stories and the connections with Eldon Street. And there's so many of them. We're just finding so much exciting stuff. And so we'll be working with artists and community groups, property owners and businesses to do some really exciting stuff over the next 3 years. So, yeah, absolutely fantastic. And this is kind of the starting point for that. It's also, I think, we need to have a bit of a shout out to Helen Ball, who kind of this idea came from Helen, and she did loads of work on it. Has gone off to a new job, I think, today. So hopefully she's watching, and huge thanks to Helen for all of the inspiration and the hard work behind this.
Do you know, we're going to start playing the music then, you know, like they do at the Oscars, because you could go on all night, couldn't you? It's like I say, it's a cast of thousands, but when you see the finished product, how pleased are you with it?
Over the moon, absolutely over the moon. I think it's wonderful. I've been sort of today, keep dipping into it and keep seeing new things. And again, that tiled floor, that is amazing. We're just so pleased. But we want to hear what other people think. Like I said, this is a pilot project, so this is just the start. So we'd love any feedback from people about what they like about it, what we could do better, how we could extend it. And hopefully we can extend this for the Civic, but also perhaps look at other buildings on Eldon Street and in the town centre. So, you know, all feedback is really welcome.
Absolutely. You did mention that under the floor and looking at the tiles, and of course, we put one person that's really kind of like lit up that side of the show for us is Luke, who is from the Civic. And we've got him with us tonight. I think what I'll do, I'll speak to you later, Tegwin. Thank you for coming on and telling us about that. That were fantastic. I've got Luke with us. I'm going to bring him in. Hi, Luke. How are you doing?
Very good. Thank you, Graham. Thanks for the invitation to be part of tonight.
Do you know what? It's something special, this, isn't it?
Yeah. I deliberately didn't try and look at any of the footage or any of the work that you've done. Obviously, I was involved in a small part with the tours and showing you around the building in the beginning, but also some of the narrative on those little video clips that you're going to show in a moment. But I deliberately didn't want to see any of it. I know the building like the back of my hand. I know a fair bit about the history, but also as it is in its present form. And I really got goosebumps when you showed it to me this morning, the experience of how it looked. I mean, the Civic is a building that's transformed with every generation. It keeps on changing and it will continue to do so. And it's just really quite intriguing to see where it began. I feel we've always continued that ethos as it opened. You know, it is for the people of Barnsley. It's a variety of entertainments and attractions and education that continues to this day to in that building. And I feel we are going from strength to strength. As you can tell, the building at the front certainly needs a little bit of tender love and care. And we're definitely keen to give it that. In the next few years, us as a trust are wanting to take over the operational running of that part of the building. Mainly the art centre is all at the back, the Mandela Gardens and Hanson Street side. We want to expand in an empty space. And I feel the Matterport tour, especially, that's the modern day version, really shows anybody watching tonight the state the building is at present from the past 10 years for various reasons. And today's not the time to go into the whys and wherefores, but it just shows you the potential and the experience. It's amazing that the Victorian journey was so closed in because you were bypassing the shops, and I felt it was really claustrophobic. You can see the potential of that foyer entrance that we've just skipped by there. Could be really open, light, welcoming. This staircase is the one on the left-hand side. The one on the right-hand side is currently boarded in. It's closed. If anybody's ever been to the assembly room and used the toilets in our theatre space, the original staircase goes up to the back of there. And it's kind of like blocked off.
The retro tour, the 1878 tour, we actually see it, don't we? And it's actually, it would have been behind that wall there.
So where that map of Barnsley is, that's where the arch on the left in the historic tour that we've seen earlier tonight. And behind that wall on the right is the other arch, which is in existence at the moment. It still physically exists, that arch.
One of the things that we really loved was actually coming down here, and it was great for you to actually show us this, Luke, but you actually pulled the carpet back and revealed those fantastic tiles that we see on the tour as well. And in fact, if we go up into the, just to show the functionality here, if you click on these links here, they'll take you direct to various parts of the building. And just here, you actually did a lovely little piece of video, which is here. If we can just play, I'll just see if I can play this.
Okay. Are we having my sound or shall I talk over him? I'll talk over myself.
have you got no sound on there?
Yeah, the tiles underneath, every time I pull up that bit of carpet just to show somebody what's there, I'm so tempted to rip it up even further because it is so intriguing. There is some damage. We don't really know what the state of it all is like. And I hope it looks as fabulous as what Marcus has recreated, but I think there's a bit more damage than it looks on the model.
This is the bit, isn't it, where we actually got you walking down here and pulling up the carpet. But you do this for visitors. You do tours of the building, I think, Luke.
Yeah, I've been at the Civic for 7.5-8 years, and I've done various tours, not always in this front part, from council staff, our Heritage Open Day weekends, when we have those in September, school groups, Rotary clubs, anybody that ever wants to come and have a look around the building, if we've got time to show them around, we can always make that happen. Obviously, situations are slightly more challenging in current circumstances, but thankfully, we've been able to still do that with where necessary in a safe manner. Say, this has all been done within the restrictions and within
absolutely,
this
absolutely. And do you know what? We don't want to give everything away, but if you go on here, there's lots of fantastic little video clips that actually bring the tour to life. So even though people can't go and look around it in person just quite yet, they can actually do this big tour. And we take you right up onto the top floor, where this used to be the School of Art, didn't it, for about 60 years, going back a long, long time. And this was the old headmaster's room, I think, in this area.
Yeah.
And we've got some video of you actually explaining all that. And then into this part of the building, so we're right at the top of the Civic at this point.
This is a great point to look up. If you could go back right, Graham, just to show that ceiling and the arches and the roof, because many people who know it of old may remember that part of the building. It's important to say that this part of the building is tenanted by Barnsley Council, They do have some services based in the building, which you don't see during the tour because it wasn't really appropriate to film it in that part. The building where we had staff working very confidential work and important work. And then the art centre is all at the back. And you did include the assembly room, I believe, which is our theatre and performance multi-use space within the tour, so people can explore.
We've got empty floors
as well, which I think are really fascinating for people because this really gives everybody access into the building to spaces that they wouldn't normally get access to. And I think access to buildings with the situation of the pandemic has been so restricted, just as a general point, that actually this is a great way of exploring and taking it in your own time and seeing around because, you know, it is warts and all. It shows the state that, unfortunately, some of the buildings in. But I also want, I'd love people to look at it and seeing the potential because we don't want to leave it like this. We've got a scheme. We've been working with HLM Architects, David Hobson from Hobson Haig as our project manager. And with the support of Tegwyn, with the support of Barnsley Council and the Historic England and the Heritage High Street Action Zone, we've been able to really progress our plans so far to a great state. And on our website, on barnsleycivic.co.uk, I'd like to highlight that, of course, this tour will be on there so people can have a look around as well. We've also got the capital project on there, which has some more details and some indicative plans of the layout and our proposals for the space. It has developed slightly since those plans were on there. And most importantly, we are a charity and the public engagement and support is always appreciated. And conveniently, we've placed a little support us logo in the top right hand corner. And anybody that can support with the project in any way whatsoever, we really do appreciate that.
That's fantastic. We've just been trying to show a little bit more of this while we're doing it as well. And if you click on these links here, these will take you into the 1878 tour. And I think we've managed to get the audio working on this now. Tell me if you can hear this. Are we back? We're working.
Yeah.
So and then I cut you off. Let me bring you a bit more centre screen. You're having too much airtime. Here we go. Let's see if I can bring this up.
The new Barnsley Mechanics Institute opened in January 1878. Although much has changed since then, you can still see that the building was designed to impress. It was also designed to inspire ordinary people of all ages to engage with culture, science, and the arts through education and cultural activities. The new building had shops on the ground floor with offices and the School of Art above. It also included a library, reading room, lecture theatre, and a club room for members. There was also a grand public hall behind the Institute, now the Civic Barnsley. I'm standing in the original grand entrance hall from Eldon Street. These tiles were put in 1910. They replaced the original 1870s tiles, which had been worn away and trod on by thousands of feet visiting the building.
So that's one of the examples of the many, many videos that we've got in there. And some great, great work, Kurt Luke. Do you still get a buzz going around there? You're still finding new things?
Oh, yeah. I mean, I'd worked there for about 6-7 years before I discovered the staircase, the hidden staircase that was basically in a cupboard. And we had a Quality Street tin full of keys and I ratched through it. And we had an artist in residence, Lynn Barker, and we were so keen to know what was behind the cupboard and we just couldn't believe it. It was a little bit of our Tutankhamun tomb, as it were. There's always little new things to discover as well. And when we managed to go through those doors for the first time as well, that was quite exciting. So that staircase I'm talking about is basically to the left behind that white section of wall that you can see on the left. That's where that other run of stairs would be.
Yeah, and this would be the reading room, wouldn't it, that we actually looked on the 1878 tour? That would be in this room, wouldn't it?
Correct, yes. So this is on the on ground zero. So as you come in, if you went through those walls there, you'd get to the Mandela Gardens. And then that also really gives you an indication about the width of the building. It was a very long and quite narrow building. It's only 17 meters wide. And that kind of really explains why when they developed it in 2007, 2008, it was an L-shaped extension. And, you know, the present art centre, the majority of that is in that extension, and with the assembly room being the historic part.
I think when you like look up in the ceiling as well, you'll see all the architecture that's been put into the 1878 version. It really is a very, very authentic, isn't it, Luke?
Yeah. I mean, because of the process that Marcus and his team followed, which was that physical scanning, so that footprint is absolutely accurate, relying on the plans that we have from the archives and really the discovery of some of the information, because some things can often aren't necessarily in the first place that you look. And they've been really tenacious and constantly digging, which we've found out new things throughout this process. So it's been extremely exciting for Tegwin and myself. Constant exchange of emails every time we discover something new. And it really has informed our understanding of the building. But as I say, the uses of the space has changed throughout the generations.
And this again is that room, the big space room that we've just come out of. So this is to show where that actually sits now. I think what the modern day approach has done is to put this in perspective, hasn't it? So it gives you a real feeling of what this must have been like to have been in this building. Very dark and dingy as well compared
with... Well, that's what I say. This corridor feels quite claustrophobic as an experience, but it was all about getting to that destination of that reading room and to the staircase to get you where you needed to be, and less of a focus on that overall journey through and engaging, because it could be quite... now I feel, although grand and the detail in the facade is fantastic, it can be a bit of a barrier, and we're wanting that feeling to be more of a welcoming space coming in, but also to have that feeling of the awe and the grandeur, because the height, the double height as you come through that corridor, those arches are just spectacular that we can still have an experience today. And you know, the staircase as well. And we are proposing to restore the side that is closed off as well, which is really exciting.
Yeah, absolutely superb. Well, listen, I'm enamoured by it, to be honest with you. I just think it's just a wonderful piece of work. I really hope that you manage to do more of the building. I hope that that we've not just stopped at that entrance point, because I think the rest of the building is fascinating with its own stories to be told. Is that the plan? Are we going to see more of this?
Well, we really hope so, because I think there's so much more of the story to tell. We focus here on the first 10 years. So, of course, there's many more decades to talk about, and the way that story's changed. And also, it would be really nice to get the input of people's own personal stories, which we also did a piece of work on a couple of years ago, and getting that some anecdotes about their experiences and how people remember it. Because every generation in Barnsley seems to have to call it a different thing, one thing, but also have a key memory. And I've been very lucky to meet people who have remembered it from soup kitchens in the 40s to the Women Against Pit Closures in the 80s, and all different times. And when I've done the tours, I've often had former members of staff, and I noticed from the comments that we've had that already tonight, you know, coming back with really warm memories. Because it is a lovely place to work. It's a great and inspiring space. And I think it's something that all my colleagues are really behind and have an enthusiasm, and we're all working to that. And there's a nice comment from Mark. We'll screenshot that, because it'll be the first complimented me.
But I mean, I'll be honest with you, there's a lot of lovely comments coming in tonight. I just noticed one or two saying they'd seen people like Bill Haley who performed here. And I remember on a press night once doing an interview with Norman Wisdom down there, and he was a nearly 90 at the time. It must have been one of the last shows down at the Civic before it kind of closed as we remember it. And and I remember he had the stage especially lacquered so that he could slip and slide all over it and do his comic antics. And nearly 90, when most people are on a Zimmer frame, which I just thought were quite remarkable, but summed up the guy. So yeah, absolutely superb. We've also got. I'm going to just try and bring this up. Well, I'll just bring a picture up of today's theatre space as well, because where we've just looked at where the reading room is, and we went down and we looked, and it's very building site-ish. Just while I'm digging up the picture of the existing show space, you have got grand plans, haven't you, for that, Luke? Can you tell us anything about that?
So the space where the reference library or the reading rooms were, is that what
yes.
So our hope, and the plans are on the website, as I mentioned before, we're in a real critical part of the plans, and the project's got a huge amount of momentum, so it's really quite exciting. So really what I can say is that our proposed idea is to have a studio space down there as a theatre space, slightly more traditional in format than what we have at present. We'll also have, that will be about 150 seats. So you don't have to go right round to the back to get to it, and you can come in right from the front. We'll have also a new welcome cafe bar offer on the front across those that entrance space at the moment. So you would come in through those beautiful big doors, come through there, you turn right, and we've got an escalator concourse that many people might have seen in the Mandela Gardens. And we would have our bar area in there. We wouldn't have the underhang of the balcony because the bar area would be extended. And that would be your entrance into the studio theatre space. Also on that ground floor, we'd have a micro theatre space, which is a great area for having spoken word, different like trial performances, but then also could be hired for celebrations, events, and corporate functions, meetings, all that sort of thing. The staircase on the right-hand side would be opened up, so that allows people to circulate throughout the building. We've also got a gallery space in the Hanson Street side of the building at present, and we're proposing to extend that across the footprint of the assembly room. The gallery is a really huge part of what we do, and it attracts some fantastic exhibitions, which we sometimes self-curate or bring in. Like in August, we've got a fantastic exhibition called Body Beautiful coming from National Museums of Scotland, which we're really excited about. And that's starting in August. And we've got Jasper Pedio's exhibition Perfect Imperfects there at the moment. You then continue up that grand staircase to essentially that corner. Can you just move your cursor to the right there? That door there, more or less, where you were, that staircase will bring you up there where the toilet blocks are. And we're hoping that you would no longer have to come into the assembly room to use the facilities, that you could use the toilets outside of the room as well. And we'd hope that the additional studio space would allow us to do a more variety of events in here, so we could have more of the weddings and functions and the big celebratory events, as well as we'll still have some of our performances that need that bigger space, you know, like some of the dance events and some of the very big named comedians that we've had and continue to have. We had our first show back after the pandemic with Gary Delaney, a stand-up comedian, last week. And we've got Toby Foster, Last Laugh Comedy Club. I'm plugging away here, Graham.
Yeah, keep going.
This weekend, and I do believe there's still tickets available. We also have dance schools coming to perform with us. And because of the capacity that we've got lots of backstage rooms. It means, A, we can deliver that in a COVID-secure manner, but B, it makes us a really appealing venue for that. And hopefully by spreading out our artistic activity across the other spaces, it means less pressure on that space to enable us to use it for different things as well. And I think that's probably covered all the key.
You have. I think the only thing that it'd be remiss of me not to ask you about is the fact that obviously you've had, along with every other venue in the country, the most challenging 18 months of all time. How difficult and challenging has it been, and can you see some light now coming down that tunnel? Obviously you've got some shows planned.
Obviously it has been difficult for everybody. I think it's been difficult for people on a personal level, but certainly as an organization, because there's always that fear, the vulnerability for the sector. I think our multi-use has really benefited us, because we've been able to have clients still use the spaces as and when appropriate and when permitted, of course, like St. John's Ambulance for mandatory training. And we've got other groups like that we've been able to do. We've also got great relationship with some of the theatre and dance schools who have been able to do summer schools like Stagecoach and also Pauline Quirk Academy, who have used us on Saturday. So that's been really great to have their support, and they've been able to work and cooperate with us in making sure that we're doing this all safely for our staff, for them and for their children and young people who are working there. Claire Taylor's saying, can't wait to see Bootleg Blondie again. Yep, they are coming back, I believe. And they are great actors well to see. So we have all sorts of shows coming to see it. We feel like it was a real big milestone having the performance last weekend, and I understand the atmosphere was really strong. And when Gary Delaney announced that, you know, he was delighted to be the first show back, the audience's applause were just overwhelming. And, you know, even some of my hardened colleagues said that they found that emotional when it started, and the audience's reaction. And I've said it before and I'll say it again, we really do appreciate the public support that we have. We know that there's a lot of love for the Civic as a building, because it's
terrific.
It's very personal. There's lots of memories, and we really do respect that. And we do appreciate it.
Listen, and you know what? The public just at large, and we can't wait for live entertainment to be back. And God bless all you guys who are sticking with it and are going to bring that back to the party very soon. And look, thanks for all your fantastic kind of background knowledge on this project as well. It's been quite remarkable. And what I would say to anybody is that obviously we've only given you a little bit of a sneak peek preview tonight, but please jump onto the tour. We've got the links on the bottom here straight after this, and have a look round. And I'm sure you'll find it fascinating with lots of other great information in there. So, look, thanks for joining us tonight. No doubt I'll be seeing you very soon.
Thank you very much, Graham. And also, like, a big thanks to you for the work that you've put in as well. The results are just absolutely fantastic. And thank you also for letting me use this as for plugging and talking about all the great things that we're doing and looking forward to in the future. Much appreciated.
Yeah, I'll be down there for a free drink at some stage, I'm sure. I'm going to bring Marcus back into the show, so he can actually just remind us again about this fantastic project that he's been working on. Marcus, I think the comments speak for themselves. People are loving this. What do you think is the most kind of enjoyable thing about producing it? I mean, what have you got out of it personally?
I think because when you actually start working on a project like this, what you start with is just a map, a plan, an etching somewhere, or, you know, the laser scan data and some historic features that are actually hidden in the building, like the tiles and stuff, and actually pulling that all together and then building it and then potentially being the first person to visualize that since it was actually, you know, created is actually a really good and fulfilling thing to do.
Yeah, I'm sure. And I must admit, I've enjoyed them. It's been a question of education, but entertaining as well, in terms of looking around this and discovering more and more about the building and about the people who made it tick. And I'm sure there's a lot more to do. I mean, obviously, you've only kind of put your toes in the water, really, in the Civic. There's still quite a lot of the building to go at. Is that on your agenda? And what other projects are you working on? I mean, this is fascinating.
Well, I'd love to do the all the way up to the top of the stairs, you know, where you've got the museum at the top of the stairs. To do the whole building would be amazing and just have all, you know, lots of different things. One of the things I'm quite keen on is maybe doing some of the shops on the front, so you could go in and explore like the items and the people who were selling things at the time. That would be quite a good, they're shuttered up at the moment, but you could take those shutters away and like actually recreate the shop frontages and the insides of the shops would be a really nice thing to do, you know. So I look forward to doing that. There's loads of potential on this project. Loads of potential.
So well, I'm just going to bring Tegwin back into the stream while we're on as well. Tegwin, just tell us that there is more happening in the Eldon Street project, isn't there? Can you just tell us a little bit more about it generally?
There's loads happening. We're working with building owners on Eldon Street, offering them grants to do up their historic properties. We're working with the Civic, as Luke said, looking at helping them to restore the building and restore some of those amazing features like those tiles, which we're really excited to see. We're also doing lots of engagement work. We're working with local artists. I don't know if everyone's seen the coloured crates that went in on Eldon Street a few weeks ago.
Sure.
They were celebrating kind of travelling performers that came to Eldon Street over the years and from all over the world to perform here in Barnsley. So really working sort of with all of those stories to help rejuvenate the High Street, help people celebrate the High Street, obviously working with colleagues in museums and archives to uncover some of that stuff, working with lots of brilliant volunteers. So there's just absolutely loads happening. Working with a college with their enterprise students, trying to encourage independent businesses and support the growth of independent businesses on Eldon Street as part of that town centre regeneration. And becoming a link between the new glassworks development and all the amazing cultural stuff we have with Experience Barnsley, the Cooper Art Gallery in the old town. So just loads going on. Really exciting 3 years.
Well, I think the other thing to remember as well is that, I mean, there are some fantastic buildings down there that everybody remembers, like the Benjamin Arrows kind of jeweler shop with a big clock outside. I think that's been renovated, hasn't it? And then there's
So that's one of our priority buildings. Also Globe Travel and Leslie Francis kind of key priority buildings that we're working with.
So I reckon everybody's booked an holiday out of Globe Travel in Barnsley, and I think everybody's had their haircut at Leslie Francis as well. So I suppose there are some great stories there. But you look at the arcade as well, the old Victorian arcade. That's part of the project, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely. So trying to promote the arcade those amazing kind of historic spaces sort of around Eldon Street. And like you said, some of the buildings, if people just look up, there's some amazing, amazing architectural details and amazing stories to go with them. I mean, Leslie Francis used to be Porter's and Sons. It was A. Porter. And actually, we found out that was Anne Porter, who set the business up with her sons in the late 19th century and ran it as a department store for a number of generations. And all sorts of brilliant things. Harold's, you mentioned, we found out the other week that they had a time ball on the front of the shop, which was linked to the Eiffel Tower in Paris.
Wow.
So basically every day there was a radio signal from the Eiffel Tower in Paris and the time ball dropped on the front of Harold's shop so everyone knew it was 11 o'clock. Stuff like that. I mean, it's just, you know, Eldon Street was connected to all sorts of places. Yeah.
Incredible. And you know what? I think preserving it now is a key thing to do. But actually, when you think about the fact that what we're doing here is allowing people to step back in time And Marcus, you've done that. I mean, I'd like to see you rebuild the entire Barnsley Town Centre of 1878. how long would that take you?
I don't know. We could do the street, couldn't we? We could do that street. If we could find some decent photography of it, we could
I think the other thing is as well would be to bring all the shops back to life as well. I mean, some of these shops that we've just mentioned, I remember Neil's music shop in the arcade where I think I brought my first record. It'd be great to actually step back in there. And it's only with the wonder of technology, but we can actually time travel now.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it's just been amazing just to see the Civic come to life in this way. And I think we've all been extremely excited to sort of see how it's all come together because we've all been involved in finding the plans and understanding the history and looking at those stories. But just to actually see it visualised in a way that we can actually explore it. And like Marcus said, you can look at the details and you can look up and look round and just experience what it was like to be there. It's just incredible.
It is. It's been fantastic. And I've really enjoyed tonight as well, folks. Thanks for giving up your time for us to have a look around here. I'm just going to say good night to everybody, but I'm just going to bring Luke back in. Luke, thanks as well for your time. It's been absolutely tremendous. I think we need to do more of these, and we've had a fantastic response online as well so far. Just reminding people constantly, we've got that little trail on the bottom there to have a look. It's 1878.barnsleycivic.co.uk. You jump in there, you'll find out, you'll be able to have a go at this for yourselves. And the only thing I'm going to say is, you know, don't do it too late, or you'll not get to bed, you'll not get to sleep. It's just a great tour, but it's compulsive viewing, let's put it that way. Again, thank you everybody for joining me tonight, and thank you for everybody who's been watching out there. Your evening is still quite young, you've still got a lot more you can do, but do tell everybody about this stream and share it with your family and friends. Let them have a look and find out about why we've been raving tonight about this absolutely fantastic building here in Barnsley and why you should have a look around it. And when you get the chance, Luke will be doing tours down there as well. You can actually go around and have a look around, but you'll also be able to buy tickets and go see some of the fabulous shows that we've been reminiscing about tonight as well. So I'm just going to leave you folks tonight with just a little bit more video just to show off this fantastic building, fantastic tour that we've been looking at. Enjoy this, tell all your friends about it, and we'll see you soon.